We got Ying Liu hats.
How did you produce this whole thing independently?
I was lucky that year, actually, because I was a writer for China for a few years, and then I had that idea. It's actually only like a 2-minute idea. I think I can shoot it in 2 minutes, so it's a high concept. And then I also met a composer friend who said, hey, let's make musicals, let's make musicals. So I figured, hey, this story is too short, so if I make it into a musical, I can actually stretch it. And then I also realized it's really much faster for me to write lyrics than scripts, so it's kind of really cheap a little bit. And then that year there was an investor friend who's, you know, a young girl. She's from a big real estate family. So she actually approached me 3 years ago, but I wasn't ready. I didn't want to spend other people's money to be responsible. And so she said, hey, let's start a company. So we started a company. And I figured I need to have something to show, so I wanted to make a short film, and she was supportive. So even though we didn't have a big budget, the lucky thing is, like, people like Sean, he's basically reached for me. I couldn't afford him, honestly. He's like a Keo winning, and you know, he's done feature films, won national awards in China. So, but luckily, as a short film, there's just so much support. People will come and just, hey, you know, it doesn't matter. So that was my lucky year. I got to make this film, and with a really awesome investor. And then, you know, economics changes, and, you know, so now she can't do anything, but hey, I got a film out of it.
Why don't we all commit to the light and not taking pictures of us? So tell us a little bit about amazing choreography. Like, where did that come from?
That's Ryan Fun. He's a member of the Quest crew, which is an Asian dance crew from LA, from Sierra. So they've actually won the Emmys and twice MTV's Mammoth's top dance crew. So, but he's very low key, so I didn't even know he was so illustrious at the beginning. And like, just like Sean, they're all very, you know, sort of helpful. And I just had the best crew from, especially the people from LA. They were, you know, the Chinese people were great too, but it's a different culture because there's web movies and web shows, so short films, they don't understand it. You know, why wouldn't you make something that would make the money back so we can, you know, I'll be part of it and we'll do something later. But since I've been a writer for a few years, I wanted to start with a short film, so I can, you know, make my mistakes. So we'll probably, Ryan and I will probably do, and Sean and Gerald. Leonardo is the one that shot the study camp part of the dance, and he's also the one bringing tea to the couple. So so the extras are basically my crew. If you just look at that, and my investors in there too. So we plan to shoot something in LA together.
Let's open it up to questions from the audience.
Where did you shoot?
It's a town called Hangzhou. It's Hangzhou, and it's maybe 2 hours by car from Shanghai, south of Shanghai. It's the capital.
It's on the east coast.
Yeah.
And how long was the shooting process? I mean, how long did you take to shoot the film?
Yeah, it was 8 days, and Sean was a trooper because you can say that, you know, part yourself.
Well, I was doing a movie in Chongqing at the Red Eye Theater. To do a movie, and then she called while I was in New Orleans, so I went from New Orleans back to Beijing, to Red Eye, and then to Hangzhou, and yeah. She was gracious enough to do a lot of the scouting prep without me, so I fell in love with the script.
Yeah,
So when I finished, I think it was just about my 180th day straight. But the project was something I felt I needed to shoot.
What do you do to skip this particular piece?
Oh, it's just heartbreaking and wonderful. Yeah. I mean, I tear up at the end, and I've seen it a dozen times.
The public transport in the beginning, what was the process? Did you guys have to close it off to ensure that they were the only two people there? Was it shot late at night or early in the morning?
I think that's my biggest accomplishment. Honestly, it's my first film in China, so I would just confess, I spend most of my time producing. So that was Hangzhou Metro, the subway in Hangzhou. In LA, it would be impossible to shoot.
It would be impossible in Hangzhou. I mean, it is packed. It was a miracle that she was able to get clearance.
I had to actually write a proposal because, you know, so I actually shamelessly used my crew's credits because I'm like, hey, if you want Sean to shoot a commercial for you, it's going to cost you millions of yuan. So, but they're willing to do this for me. So it's a good publicity for the Hangzhou Metro.
Of course, they said Sean who?
So we got lucky, and we shot after they closed down. So it was after we started maybe 10:30, 11-ish at night, and the train was actually moving, which is great, and not great at the same time because we only have a certain amount of time. And then they're like, oh, don't worry about the 4-hour limit. And we got so excited, and we were like...
It wasn't about 3.5 hours where the operators got tired and said we're done?
Well, they actually did kick us out because they said we actually have to do maintenance, like the train actually has to start running again. So then we didn't get done, so we need to shoot one more day. So I told them, hey, we only have this much budget, so I'll pay for it the next day myself. So the lady said, oh, I'll talk to the boss. And then she told me later that I don't have to pay, so we got one day extra. It was like 4 a.m. and the crew were really tired and I felt bad. And the producer was like, are you kidding me? Like, this is the first time everyone's shot in the train, for real, in train station. And we could like actually have the guy do the, because the escalator was all shut down.
So. That's your way to run behind him and turn it off.
Yeah, so they were really, it was just a powerful moment, you know, turn it back on. So.
It's really that clean?
Yeah.
Yes, it is. Wow.
Yeah, it's
clean, fast, quiet is amazing.
Oh, it's new? It's new?
It's not bad new, but I think a lot of the Chinese cosmopolitan cities do look like that because everything, because LA was built, I live in LA now, LA was built, you know, I don't know, many years ago, but a lot of those structures are built recently.
Yeah, that doesn't look like the red line.
Can you tell us a little bit about your actors?
That's also an interesting story. Because I wrote it for 28 to 30, early 30s, that age range. So when I went back to China, it was a reality check because they're like, okay, if you want 28-year-olds, it's going to be way more expensive. So if you get the like sort of fresh out of school people, it'll be cheaper. Because actors in China have a really good time because there's so many projects. So I went with those younger people. But so it's harder for them to understand that the happy ever after part of life, where you know, you only see the romantic comedies where they get together, but you don't know how it is after that, as you would know by this time. So, but then actually the surprising part was my actor, both of them were actually already signed by the agencies. So I had to deal with the agents and I really missed Hollywood where the actors would just show up and just sign a release and just do it. So the contracts took half a month pre-production time. So I have to like rewrite them, you know. So all of my actors, the guy just graduated from Central Drama Academy, he's sort of a top student there. And the girl was a junior at the same school. And I presumed that she had training, but she actually didn't because she was in the dance major. So she's absolutely new and she didn't know how to act. So but she's very elegant and, you know, the boys all liked her. So.
Well, the genuine moment of her breaking up when he's loading the food in the bowl, it was just precious.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
That was just her. You know, not
yeah.
Too.
Yeah. Yeah. We told the guy to actually surprise her. So that scene, the guy actually did something funny that she didn't know he was going to do. So he just sort of, you know, helped her a little bit.
Just curious, what would you estimate your budget in dollars, and what took the most chunk of it, because you had such good quality, you know, content and editing, so
We did have a budget, but it's way lower than what would have cost if this were a commercial. So the music was made in, the fast songs were actually expensive, because we had two fast songs. So that was in Hollywood, Elton Avenue did it. And but still, he's like, I'm only charging one tenth of, you know, whatever I charge this big singer. And then the slower music is done by Tao Liu, who actually was one of the composers on Wandering Earth, which is like this legit Chinese film.
Sci-fi
movie. So we were lucky that we actually have a budget, but it wouldn't actually make sense to you if I tell you the dollar amount, because the currency makes it sort of like, you know, so it's not the same value.
That's why I'm curious.
We don't
filmmakers on the spot.
But we're just lucky because we had like a giant, big supportive team from Hollywood who's basically just, you know, doing this out of passion. Mm-hmm. And the Chinese team was. I got the art director, he was a commercial art director, so I think he also just really liked the project, and then he went out to do Dead Pigs, my crew was just awesome.
But also, the film culture there is very different. When you sign a contract, you work 7 days a week, any hours, and it usually nets out around 100 to 110 hours a week. So that's where there's a real rift in the money, and in fact, equipment is much more expensive there, so you end up driving your crews to get the equipment off-road. And what helped is my crew, I've done 6 movies with them, so they came in, they've got very deep relationships with rental houses, so because it was a passion project, you know, we all kind of chipped in and helped.
Yeah, if it weren't for Sean, they wouldn't. So I was so worried. Every day is like, are they coming?
The relationship's good enough, they'll walk off and just work with me. So,
Showed up on the screen. It's really beautiful. So, what are both of you doing next?
I'm back doing commercials and reading scripts. Ironically, I was so busy in 2016 17, created a sales gap, and none of the movies had come out, so I had nothing to show. So, now the trailers start to come out, and the scripts start to come out. But it's interesting that I worked too much and created a whole. Unfortunately,
that's why you can be here.
In fact, I was supposed to have a meeting on the script and.
With Russell Crowe. And he ditched them and came to us. So.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Oh, no, this is wonderful.
What about you? What are you doing next?
I actually had to go back to being a writer to support my family. Because my investments are money, Olson. So I'm adapting Miss Congeniality for Warner Brothers China and Village Roadshow. And I sort of, well, I didn't. Actually, the director of the project liked the script that I wrote on spec. So he urged Village Roadshow China to do it. So I was lucky enough, through him, I sold that script to them. So those are the two things I would be doing as a writer next. And then, hopefully, Sean and I and Ryan will shoot something in LA and, you know, enjoy the benefit of this weekend. All the time.
Well, awesome. Thank you both for being here.
Thank you.